Hello, my name is Danica Stewart, and today I am going to be presenting my initial journal for my AQ primary and junior math course. Which grades am I currently teaching? Well, this year I have been granted the incredible opportunity to teach a grade 7 and 8 remote class since September from my home due to health conditions. My students are from various schools around Barrie, Angus, and Orillia, and also Wasaga. Some of my students I've been teaching for years as an FSL teacher, and also some of them I've been teaching since kindergarten as a planning time teacher. The actual grade range for my students goes anywhere from grade 5 with IEP level students all the way up to gifted learners who are engaging in Gauss math currently through the University of Waterloo. How learning happens in my classroom. As a remote teacher, and as all of us are remote teachers right now, learning isn't always evident, except when my students are very interactive in the online learning environment. I have had many students who remain muted, turn in very little work, and do not do any assignments. However, oftentimes during our asynchronous block at the end of the day, many of my very quiet students can ask me for support, and I audibly hear their aha moments, which is so fantastic. Learning happens outdoors, digitally, with a pencil and paper learning, and especially in a cross-curricular way. I'm always seeking out opportunities to provide my students with the chance to learn in different ways. We learn and discuss together and learn through a lot of mistakes. I always encourage my students to make mistakes, as it is truly the best way to learn math. I often make videos to share with my students to explain where they made a mistake, and I encourage them to reply with their understanding. What teaching looks like in my mathematics classroom. In an online classroom, teaching has been a real struggle, to be honest. I have never taught math, and for the first time I've ever taught math, I'm teaching in a remote environment. Talk about new learning experiences for both myself and my students. I like to shake it up with math games, slideshows, outdoor math, video tutorials, theme days, and injecting math into many other subjects like phys ed. I am very patient with students, but I find that there are only a select few that interact, so I am not always sure that my teaching style is benefiting all students as best it could. Whereas in a classroom, immediate feedback, expressions on faces, and seeing blank papers would inform me a lot more. Demonstrations live, turning into other math pros, and fun math resource sites are also a regular part of my instructional day too. The role of my students. Here I am saying, try! I have a respectful, patient, and wonderful group of intermediate students. They are, however, not always willing to put in the work or show their understanding, which is very common in online classes. Their role, as I have told them, is to try, fail, show their work, and ask for help, and listen when others are getting help. They are encouraged to make mistakes, and they have the very important task of turning in rough work, explaining what frustrated them, and what helped them to solve their problems. What are my strengths in mathematics? I wish I could do that. My strengths in mathematics stem from my personal schooling experience of rote memorization and also being in a gifted math program as a child. This lifelong but outdated skill has helped me teach formulas and solve problems with ease. I never coded before this year, but through workshops, extracurricular activities, and special guest speakers in my classroom, including the coding camp, which was fantastic, I have become really fascinated with coding. My students, in return, seem to be most interested in coding too, which informs me that our enthusiasm for different strands can really affect how our students are learning. Areas in math which I'd like to improve. I would love to improve a lot of things about my teaching style in math. I am always trying to keep students motivated, engaged in their online learning, but with such a variety of learning styles and levels, this has proven to be a very big challenge. I would like to be able to attend more workshops, take more online courses, and be one of those amazing math teachers that makes math fun. I need to realize that making mistakes as a teacher is also part of the learning process, and that I need to relax a little more and let my students fail and learn from their mistakes. For me, that's still hard, though I do encourage students to just try their best. Learning goals for this course. My learning goals for this course include becoming familiar with the primary and junior curriculum, as I have never taught math at all, and I have never had any experience teaching primary or junior math. I'd also like to help make lessons each have a minds-on connection. A personal goal would be to understand what my soon-to-be grade 4 son Phoenix is learning and why he's doing math the way he is. It doesn't always make sense to me until I review his teacher's videos. I'd like to find tips and tricks to inspire my learners and be able to give my students more lifelong tools for success in mathematics. And on a scale of 1 to 10, how confident am I with math? I'd say I'm a 5. Personally, I feel that I have a strong grasp of math. But as a new to math teacher, pardon me, I feel that I'm right in the middle of this confidence level at a solid 5. I understand everything that I'm teaching, but I don't always feel that my lessons are resonating with my students, and I strive to make this something with which I have full confidence. Thank you for listening today, and I look forward to meeting all of you in this online math course. Until next time, bye.